Mosasaurs are a group of extinct marine lizards that lived during the Late Cretaceous. Imagine a Komodo dragon, except it's the size of a school bus, with flipper-like limbs, a shark-like tail, and an extra row of teeth on the roof of its mouth. I think the biggest misconception is that they are dinosaurs, which is not the case.
We have many students come here, particularly working on dinosaurs. She's the only student interested in Mosasaurus.
It was really exciting when the glass came off, because the glass has not come off in 30 years since the hall has been renovated. So it was really cool to be the first person to touch these fossils in 30 years. Part of my research here is describing that fossil so we can better understand that group of mosasaurs as a whole. Mosasaurs were fully marine, which means that they did not return to the land. Their fossils have been found on every continent, including Antarctica, because they were living in the oceans and crossing the oceans. We actually have fossils of the same species in Europe as we do on the east coast of North America. Mosasaurs lived between 100 and 66 million years ago, and they went extinct with the same asteroid that killed the dinosaurs.
Mosasaurus, it's a marine reptile, specifically it's a marine lizard. So this animal, although it has big teeth, it's not a dinosaur. We don't see any dinosaur lived in the marine environment.
The reptile evolutionary tree has two main branches, the archosaurs and the lepidosaurs. Dinosaurs, birds, crocs, and turtles belong to the archosaur branch, and mosasaurs and other lizards and snakes belong to the lepidosaur branch.
Mosasaurs have been studied for many years, but still there are many very basic issues. But right now, for example, whether it's more closely related to lizard or snakes, it's still a debatable issue.
The biggest lizards alive today are the Komodo dragons, which are about 10 feet long. The largest pythons get to be 26 to 30 feet long. The biggest mosasaurs that we have found so far are estimated to have been almost 50 feet long, which is bigger than a school bus and bigger than any T-Rex. So they're very big.
We want to study their evolutionary path, how they became a terrestrial animal and gradually evolved into an aquatic animal. Animals going from the terrestrial life, going back to ocean, tend to become a large body size because you don't have to carry your body. If you walk on the ground, the gravity will bring you down to the surface. You have to spend more energy. But in the water, you don't have that problem.
We think mosasaurs were able to grow to be so big because they had a lot of food available to them. Mosasaurs would eat basically anything and everything that moved. We know that based on the shapes of their teeth, their actual stomach contents, and bite marks on other animals that lived with mosasaurs.
Similar to mammals, in mosasaurs, the teeth is implanted into the jawbone. This is different from the other reptiles. It's more stable, so you can apply more power on those teeth to handle your prey, to handle your food.
People might think that mosasaurs looked like crocodiles with armored skin, when really that's not the case. We actually have skin impressions of real mosasaur skin where we can see that the scales are kind of diamond-shaped and they have a little keel down the middle, which is very similar to if you've ever seen shark skin under a microscope, so that would have helped them to swim faster. This is Tylosaurus prorigur. It was first described in 1899, and it has not been described in the literature since. The little one, the Clydastes, has actually never been formally described, which is a little bit insane if you think about it, because it is a nearly complete skeleton, and the skull is in almost perfect condition.
Perfectly preserved fossils are very, very rare. The percentage of real specimens on display are the highest in any museum.
I hope that by looking at different features in a little bit more detail and using modern techniques like CT scanning and surface scanning, we can better understand mosasaurs.